In this video, we're going to learn how to use this HT1621 six-digit LCD display. In this, we can display numbers, you can display certain characters, and it has also a battery board. Easy to use.
Hi, welcome to an Arduino step-by-step course by RoboJax.
This is sold on Banggood for around $6.36 with different color available, so you can purchase it in green, gray, blue with $3.03. I'll provide you the link. This is a display, very simple. We have few wires, actually three wires for data and programming, and two wires are for the power, ground and power. This can be connected to 5 volts. As you can see, we have six digits and we have only three decimal places, three decimal points. So you cannot have decimal point here. Up to three decimal places, you can have one decimal place, two or three. And the screen quality is very good. This is a thickness, and it has backlight. The main chip is located in here. So this is the main chip and all the pins are labeled, so you don't need to do anything except load the library and then display the text. This module cannot be used as clock because it does not have the column symbol. And here is the wiring diagram. CS pin is connected to pin 6. Right pin is connected to 7, data pin is connected to 8. They are in the same order. GND or ground is connected to ground, and VCC is connected to 5 volts. The last pin is not connected in this case. And here is the actual wiring with Arduino. Blue pin, the first line, is connected to pin 6. WR pin, green, is connected to pin 7. And then data is yellow, it has been connected to pin 8. GND pin from the last third, orange, is connected to ground. And from the last second, VCC, red, is connected to 5 volts here. Now let me explain the code. First, you need to install the library. Open your Arduino IDE, then click on Sketch, Include Library, Manage Libraries. Wait for this bar graph to complete so you can type. And type here HT1621. Wait for the list to refresh. And this is the one by Valerio New. HT16 by Valerio New. As you can see, it says installed. In your case, you will see the install here. Click install and wait for the bar graph to complete and then close it. If I go on file, example, scroll down until you see HT1621, you will see these examples. So the one that we are using is this Hello World. This is a code that I'm just opening. This line defines the CS pin, and then the right pin, and then the data pin 6, 7, and 8. And this is a line that is including the library. From this class, we create an instance of a library called LCD, and then we always refer to that inside the code. This line is using LCD.begin, passing those three lines. And 10 is for, it says for the backlight, but this LCD already has backlight, which I have not connected it. It says if no backlight is given, then use like this. So we don't worry about this. And this, it's if the backlight is there, this will control it and this will clear the screen. This line is just printing the value. If I upload this and show you, you will see it. So this code is printing this on the screen. This is just a loop with one millisecond. It just goes continuously. So we are getting the millis. Millis is a number that when you start your Arduino, it starts with zero. Let me just start it so you can see it. It starts with zero, and every millisecond, every second, it goes 1,000. So we are dividing it by 1,000. And then this comma means three decimal place. So we are getting the three decimal place. This is millisecond, and that's the second, 13, 14, 15 seconds since I started this Arduino. So in your case, if you want to display, let's say 5.36 something. Now, because we set three decimal place, the three of this will be displayed. Let me upload it. So three decimal place. And as you can see, we don't have more, one, two, three, not more than three. But if you want to display two decimal places, here, this is now two decimal places. So this is as simple as that. You just put this line and put your number. If you have a temperature or anything, you just put it. Then we have the battery tester exactly the same way, except here. Let me upload this code. It says LCD set battery level 1, and we have 500 millisecond delay, and then 2, 3. So this will just put 1, 2, and 3. So if you have a battery, so and you can put 0 to turn it fully off, because this says 1, 2, 3. Let me set it to 0 now, upload it. So now we will have also 0. Just wait. Now we will have 0, 1, 2, 3, and then 0. All of them will be turned off if you want. Kitchen sink. Now let me upload it. The same way from the top. Set battery level 3, so this is set inside the code, and you will have always 3, all of them are on. But then this is the text, ABC will be printed, and then YY4. So all these texts that you see with these shapes will be printed. Delay sync is the delay time that you set here. This is 1 second, so 1 second will be wait time between each value that is displayed. And this is another example, print Celsius. So we are defining the same pins, except here we have a function called print Celsius. In print Celsius, first we clear the screen. It says 0.1 and it shows 0.1. After that, 10 comes back, 0.1 at the top, and then 10. In here, we are using print Celsius, and we have tried to put 6 digits. Because we cannot print 6 digits, 1, 2, 3, 4, that's 5 and 6. We want to display degree and Celsius, so 2 digits is gone. Now this is saturated. To reduce that, we can do 4 of them. Now look, with 4 digits. Now we can do 111, or we can do 9999 because of the Celsius, and that we can show 999 here. But if I try one more 9 here extra, or maybe just 1, so this will be added, saturated, and this should show all 1111. And here, if I add one more 1, it will not be displayed. But if I have here, one 5 here, because this will fit and we have one extra, this will be saturated, and let's see how it shows. And as you can see, this is now saturated and the 5 is not displayed. But if I remove 1, the 5 will be displayed. Uploading it. And code is uploaded. As you can see, 5 is displayed properly. And if you want to know how much current it consumes, 20 milliampere. Turn it off. Let me turn it on and reboot. So same thing, 20 milliampere. If you want to purchase this multimeter, the link is below the video in the description. Please make sure to subscribe by clicking at the subscribe button in here. Thank you. Thank you for watching the tutorial from RoboJax. If you learned something and found this useful, please thumb up, as this will help my video in the search algorithm of YouTube. If you have comment or question, please post it at the comment section below. I try to answer and reply. And don't forget to subscribe so you get updates of my upcoming videos.